Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you my Windows 8 Consumer Preview and Windows 7 Ultimate Dual Boot. Recently, if you have been keeping up with the Windows 8 development, then you know that the Consumer Preview came out a few days ago, and I installed it on the day it came out, and I've been using it a bit. As you can see right now, I'm running Windows 7 Ultimate right there. And now if I close out of this and shut, give me a second to shut down. By the way, if you want to see the specs for the machine I'm running this on, it is on my channel page under the description. As you see, this is the new boot up screen. It's a fish, and there's a spinning wheel right there, which I think is pretty cool. Here we go. Here's a screen where I can choose Windows 8 Consumer Preview and Windows 7. There we go. That's actually a really fast boot up compared to Windows 7, especially if I didn't have that change between Windows 7 and Windows 8 screen. That'd probably be a lot faster. But here's the locked page, and I can just slide this up. And yes, there's, gotta put my password in. There we go. There's the new Metro interface, which you might have heard of if you've been keeping up with Windows 8. And it actually looks really cool and works really well. Unfortunately, I need to run the display in... This is just for my system, though. I need to run the display via VGA because I do have HDMI, and I run Windows 7 with HDMI, but I need VGA because at the moment the ATI drivers don't work properly and I can't fix the overscan. So that's the only reason I'm using VGA, because overscan pisses me off like hell. But as you can see, I have all the cool things here, and I can see my emails. Here's, I'll open some of the apps here, show what it looks like. For example, here's Finance, which I think looks amazing. Like, it's great how much they've changed it, and it's pretty cool how you can tie everything in with the OS. This weather. Like, when you first look at this, you really think of a tablet, but I can see why they, like, I can see that it's enough of a PC type thing to be able to use it with a mouse, because it's not like an inconvenience to use a mouse or anything. It actually works really well. Oh yeah, and then there's Internet Explorer now, the full screen Internet Explorer, which you might have heard of. See? And I can just navigate to page, youtube.com. It's full screen. Unfortunately, it still doesn't support Flash, although it does support HTML5. I'm sure they're going to be implementing Flash, it's just I have no idea why it doesn't work at the moment. Also, a new thing they added in the consumer preview was the store. And no, this is not like a review of anything, because then I'd film it with a... I wouldn't be filming it with a camera if this was just a... if this was like an actual review of the consumer preview. I'm actually just showing you guys the new stuff that has been added. They don't have any paid apps yet. So you see they have a bunch of free apps you can download, and it's actually really great. So that's my dual boots of Windows 8 Consumer Preview and Windows 7. I hope you enjoyed, and please rate, comment, subscribe.